that cast out stars of the sky. Once the sky held a million stars, stars as big as houses and stars as small as diamonds, glittered and glistened like myriads of twinkling brooches. Those who saw the stars from the ground thought they were heaven's riches. The stars loved to shine from their place in the heavens. They loved the attention given to the captivated stargazers. As time went on, more stars appeared in the sky. Soon the stars felt crowded by each other's presence. To make room, they nestled themselves in any space they found. When night became as bright as day, the stars realized they had to move fast to rid the clutter in the sky. However, they had one problem. Who among them should leave? They tried to persuade each other to set off, but everyone stayed. After an exhausting deliberation of sorts, they banished the smallest, dullest, and ugliest of their cluster. These stars weren't round like the rest. Their bodies were irregular and pointed in shape. They didn't shine kaleidoscopic colors like the rest. They only produced orange, brown, or violet hues. Because of their oddities, they posed as the perfect exiles. When the little stars found out, they pleaded to stay.
"Please don't cast us out,"
they wailed. But the luminous heavenly bodies did not listen.
"We must disperse you down below where you can stretch and enjoy the wide open space. In that way, we can have more room to unfold in great lengths up the sky."
With a mighty pitch, they hurled little stars to the earth. Down, down, down they fell. They streaked and hurtled through the sky until they fell into the sea. As they sank deeper and deeper into the water's aquamarine embrace, they lost their once luminous light. At last, they landed among the seaweed, dimmed and roughened from the fall. When they beheld their current state, they wept tears of sorrow.
"What will become of us?"
they cried. Their cries were heard by a passing school of fish. They swam to the stars and addressed them in soft voices.
"Greetings, strangers. What brings you to our waters?"
"We came from up above," the stars answered. "Banished from our home because we differ from our own kind."
The fishes felt sorry for the queer-looking life forms, and they consoled them at once.
"Don't worry. You can stay here in the sea," said the fishes.
"Then what shall we do?" asked the stars. "We've lost our spark. We can't grow down here."
"There are plenty of things you can do under the sea. We're sure you can find something to do," the fishes replied.
They lifted the stars onto their backs and toured them around the sea.
"When you find a home for yourselves, just jump off our backs," said the fishes.
The stars marveled at the sight of their new home. Everything looked more colorful compared to the eternal darkness of their own home. When they finally found a comfy spot on the seabed, they jumped off their backs and waved goodbye. Since their journey was long and tiresome, they felt a sudden craving to eat for the first time. They found mussels and barnacles attached to rocks. One by one, they swallowed them whole until there were no more. Schools and schools of fish swam by in feverish haste to find out what happened, and a variety of underwater creatures popped out from crevices under the rocks in relief. They were happy, because the barnacles and mussels that have invaded their homes are finally gone. The sea creatures thanked the stars and invited them to live among them in harmony. For many years, they graced the waters with their beautiful colors, blending with the corals, kelps, and seagrass. These once odd-looking stars that dropped from the sky long ago were now fondly called starfishes of the vast open seas.
We hope you enjoyed our story.
Please like our video and subscribe to our channel for more Nimble Tales.